So my prognosis now is I have moderate to severe COPD and pulmonary fibrosis of my lungs. I still am suffering from frozen shoulder. I still have problems with my hands. I have hand pain and foot pain. For whatever reason, I had some genetic disorder pick up and start when I woke up from the hospital. And I had these fibrous nodules form on the sheets of fascia in my hands and my feet. And I have hard times with that. But for my lungs, I have by far the biggest part of all of this is the fact that I have pulmonary fibrosis and it doesn't go away. Once the membrane of your lungs is scarred, it does not heal. It does not get better. And so now I'm permanently on oxygen. Everywhere I walk, I have a hose. Everything I do, I have something, a leash that gets, it's tethered, that gets pulled on, that gets people trip over. And every time it's my nose getting tugged on, hose getting pulled. And that's by far a very irritating daily annoyance.
What does it feel like to breathe right now?
If I take a deep breath, it's painful. If I try to take a full breath with my lungs, I feel like someone's like tied a net around them and they can't expand. And when I start doing daily tasks, my oxygen saturation drops out and I can't accomplish basic things without having to take breaks.
Were you some, I mean, I'm guessing as a deputy, you did a lot of active things prior to this. I mean,
yes.
Can you describe, did you like to do outdoor activities or like
yeah.
hiking or what was your, like what was your activity level before all this?
So I own a whitewater river raft. I regularly go rafting. I own half a dozen snowboards and skis. I was an avid backcountry and resort skier and snowboarder. I used to rock climb. I used to do a lot of active things. I've been to 32 countries backpacking. I have been sea kayaking just over 1,000 miles. I mean, I've done a lot of active things. And for 5 years, I worked at the, in Grand Junction, we have a university there, Colorado Mesa University. I worked at their outdoor program for about 5 years.
So how many of those things can you do again?
I can't do any of it. And I've calculated it, approximately $30,000 worth of outdoor gear that I don't have anything to do with.